turbocharged inline 3-cylinder, putting out 137 horsepower at 5,000 RPM, 162 pound-feet of torque available at 2,500 RPM, power sent to the front wheels through a CVT, giving you MPG numbers coming in at approximately 28 in the city, 31 highway, taking regular unleaded fuel. But so then the other engine configuration belonging to all other trim levels, essentially, including the all-wheel drive configurations for those last two trims I just mentioned, being the 1.3-liter turbocharged inline 3-cylinder once again, 155 horsepower, 5,600 RPM, 174 pound-feet of torque available at 1,600 RPM, sent to the front wheels or all wheels through a CVT. If you go with the front-wheel drive configuration, at least, if you were to opt for that all-wheel drive system, that is actually going to give you a 9-speed automatic transmission. So that's probably the one I would recommend, just for a little more driving emotion, I guess you could say. But all
there she is, you guys, the all-new 2021 Chevy Trailblazer looks a lot like a mini Blazer, in my opinion, which is a good thing. Absolutely amazing, aggressive looks. And so let's go ahead and start up front on the Trailblazer, though. Unique front end is going to be had with the Active and RS trim levels. The other trim levels are going to look essentially the same up front. Black bow tie emblem you can find with the RS that we have today. Otherwise, you're going to get that gold color emblem up front. Halogen headlights are going to come standard for all trim levels. However, having said that, there is a technology package that goes for $1,720 for the Active trim and RS. And with that, you can actually get LED headlights if you wanted to go that route. But RS badging is going to be had, of course, with the RS trim level up front there. LED daytime running lights also coming standard. And you will get LED fog lights if you were to go with the LT trim level and up. But then to make our way to the side of this one, roof rails coming with the LT trim level and up. Two-tone roof like we have here today coming with the Active and RS trim levels. You will find rear privacy glass, not for all trim levels, but actually for the LT trim level and up. I know that's super important for some people, but you could always, of course, tint that rear glass if you were to go with one of the lower trim levels. But LT trim level and up, though, is going to give it to you standard, though. But floating roof line, you can find that towards the back of the Trailblazer there. When it comes to the side mirrors, they are body-colored, power-adjustable side mirrors. They definitely look good there. Taking a look down at the wheel setup, 16-inch steel wheels with covers are going to come with the L. 17-inch silver-painted aluminum wheels coming with the LS. 17-inch gloss black aluminum wheels with the LT and Active trim levels, and the RS that we have today is going to bump that up once again to 18-inch gloss black aluminum alloy wheels. So definitely a good variation when it comes to the wheel configurations, depending upon the trim level that you go with. But making our way now to the back, there is a rear spoiler with an integrated brake light that does indeed come standard. Just below that, rear window wiper, LED taillights coming with the Active and RS trim levels. Of course, just below that, you're going to find trim level badging across the board. And just below it all, a single exhaust outlet if you go with the L, LS, or LT trim levels. However, if you were to go with the Active or RS trim level, you will get a dual exhaust outlet with chrome tips. So having said that, I do believe you guys know what we have to do next. As always, here is that exhaust clip. But now, since we are around back of the Trailblazer, when it comes to opening that rear liftgate, it is actually a manual liftgate for all trim levels. That is the standard setup, at least. However, there is an optional power liftgate, which we do, of course, have here today. A hands-free power liftgate, might I add, that comes with the sun and liftgate package, I guess, for $1,770. That, of course, also adds a panoramic sunroof, hence the first part of that name as well. So we do have that package today here. So I can press the button on the key fob. That is going to open it up. There's also a button on the liftgate itself to close it. And again, it's a hands-free liftgate, so you got that option there as well. But nonetheless, once opened up, cargo capacity comes in at 25.3 cubic feet. If that was not enough space, there is a 60-40 split, meaning the rear seats do fold down, bumping that up to 54.4 cubic feet. It's a good bit of space back there. Rear cargo lighting, of course, comes standard across the board. There are some tie-down hooks I found back there as well. Actually, a little bit of storage area to the right in the back, too. That's kind of indented a little bit back there. And also underneath the cargo floor back there, you can find a spare tire. But also, around that spare tire is actually a good bit of in-floor storage, too. So I did want to mention that. So that's going to be there for you once again as well. Making our way now to the rear legroom, though, that comes in at 39.4 inches. For reference, I'm an even 6 feet tall. This is how much space I had back there. As far as the rear ventilation goes, it comes for all trim levels. It's actually located under the front seats, as opposed to the backside of the center armrest here in the front. So I did want to mention that as well. Rear center armrest with cup holders is going to come on the Active trim and RS trims. It's going to be optional on the LT. So that is how you're going to be able to go ahead and get that. You actually have a decent amount of hookups back there for those rear passengers as well, including a phone charging port, USB charging port, and a 115-volt power outlet, surprisingly. So you can actually charge up drills or maybe a hair straightener if you're a girl back there. That is pretty cool. I was actually very surprised to see that, especially at this price point in the Trailblazer. So well done, Chevy, for that. Let's go ahead and make our way now to the front seats. Manually adjustable cloth seating coming with the L and LS. LT trim level and up is going to give you a 10-way power driver seat. RS is going to give you cloth leatherette combination. That is, of course, what we have today again. Active trim level is going to give you a full leatherette seating. And then there is a premium seating package I wanted to mention that is available for $845 for the LT trim level. That adds leatherette surfaces like the Active trim. Also actually gives you a leather-wrapped steering wheel for the LT and a rear center armrest as well. And if you were looking for heated front seats in the Trailblazer, go with the LT trim level and up. That is going to be how you're going to go ahead and get them. But having said that, when it comes down to comfiness, perfectly fine for me. Definitely, first thing I noticed is the lumbar adjustment on the driver's side seat here. So that was absolutely wonderful. And again, that 10-way power driver seat comes with the LT trim level and up, but certainly very comfortable seats here in the Trailblazer.